We're gonna start here with body pump. The first round is gonna be our warm up. We have 30 seconds of each of these exercises, and then we will get right to it. So let's go ahead. We'll get started in about 15 seconds. Our first one is gonna be arm circle. We'll start our upper body, kind of work our way down. And we hope you all enjoy it.
Yeah,
let's do it. All right, we'll start here in about 10 seconds. Again, we have our arms out wide, and we'll start with some arm circles forward. So let's go forward. Go forward like 15, we'll go backwards for 15. Small circles. Did you have a good weekend?
Pretty good.
Enjoying this beautiful weather again.
Very lucky to have space and good weather during all this.
Good. Let's go ahead and reverse those arms. Next 15, let's go ahead and just go side to side. Twisting side to side, hips stay forward.
Oh, something popped.
A crack. This one. Three more seconds. We're going to open the gate with our legs. We're going to the bottom now. So come up nice and high. We're opening the gate. Open up those hips. We're starting up a lot of lunges in the beginning.
Don't turn the video off because of that, okay?
Yeah, keep watching. Keep watching.
Stay with us. You got this.
Good. Up and around. Nice and high knee. About 5 more seconds, then we're going to close the gate. So we're open. One more open. Good. So now we're going to close the gate. It comes up and around. So open up that hip. Up and around.
Keep moving him, trying to stay balanced, but
yeah, yes,
it's not like a good place to put him.
Good, halfway there, about 10 more seconds. Then we're gonna one of my favorites, the good mornings. Good, 5 seconds. Let's get 2 more in. Let's get 1 more in. Good job. Legs apart. We're just gonna hinge forward, stick those hips back. Coming up, nice and slow with this one. Those in your hamstrings. You got a little bend in your knees. Don't lock those knees, but do keep those legs straight. Good job. A couple more seconds here. 10 more seconds, actually, and then we'll go back to the upper body, get those arms again. Good. Let's get 1 more of these in. Good job. Arms out wide. Nice little, actually, get some big circles. It's a big circles. It's big circles all about the shoulders. Reverse it, nice big open, nice and slow, no rush here. Big reach and back. Yeah, maybe like Erica, do one at a time if you like.
Maybe a little bit further for you.
Good, 1 more. Good, let's go and we'll cross them over. I love this one too.
Easy, mindless.
Yes. Using those two after those legs. Okay, let's go ahead and do a little twist in here too. Cool. Good, let's go back to that opening of the gate. Close that gate. Close.
So we have the ball stoppers too. We're out of croquet one, obviously.
Yeah.
I actually haven't been down here to see it yet. They did good. Hopefully that'll save all the croquet balls this season.
We'll lose them. 3 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's do our good Good morning. Let's get one more in here. Good. I'm gonna throw another one in here for you. A little mind teaser is we're gonna lift one knee, lateral raise. Lift knee, lateral raise. Our last one is about 35 seconds. Lift knee. Good. That's good. Good. 10 more seconds here. That was your warm up. Hope your legs are nice and warmed up for our first round of exercise. We're going to include a lot of legs. Go ahead and get a quick sip of water and we'll be right back. Hold up to me, cause I'm a little unsteady. Little unsteady. All right, welcome back. We're going to hit our first little section here. So we're going to be working for 45 seconds and we get a 15 second break. We're going to do 30 seconds and we get a 30 second break. So the first round is going to be the longer, probably more difficult one, and a short rest in there. So we're going to be alternating between three movements. Very first one, we're going to do three-way lunges. So you'll start with a big step forward, come back to center, step out to the side with the same foot, back to the center, and step back with that same foot, back to the center. And then we'll switch to the other side, go forward, side, back. If lunges bother you, I would recommend just standing, shifting all that weight into one side, into one foot, and practicing with that stability, just reaching that toe forward to the side and back. Again, returning to the center in between each one, just like we're doing with those lunges. So just do that in place and alternate feet. Next movement's gonna be an inchworm. So what you can do for these, you reach as far forward as you need to get started. The idea here is that your hands are as close to your feet as you can reach. We just wanna keep a pretty straight leg here. Walk those hands out into the plank position and then walk them back up to the feet. I like to stand up in the middle too. Just open those hips back up, give yourself a brief rest, and then back at it. Walk those hands out and back. Last move is gonna be high knee toe touches. I'm gonna show it a little bit slower, and Natasha's gonna show it nice and fast. So it's less about the knees coming up, more about the heel coming up here. So all we're trying to do is hit that heel as many times as you can, moving nice and quickly. All right, so we're gonna get started in on these. Let me get this clock.
What about for inchworm? If they don't like their wrists bother them, what should we do for?
You can do those on the wall, or do you have a better suggestion? I was gonna say, I would just get to a wall that you have to kind of lean up against and just walk your hands up and down.
Yeah.
The idea here is to hit those hamstrings more than anything. You can even just do a forward fold just as far as you can and stand up, kind of like we did with the good morning, so it'd be fine. Just working those hamstrings.
Perfect.
All right, cool. So we're gonna work for 45 seconds. We'll pull my hair back and then we're gonna start in 10. So getting ready with those three-way lunges. 3, 2, and 1. Forward, side, and reverse. Once you do all three on one side, we're switching that other side. Good job, guys.
I feel like we're doing some kind of dance move here.
I know. I was about to say, if you're not working in unison with your partner like we are, then you're wrong. Give me 10 more seconds.
Yeah, so we love hearing all the couples that are working out. So please keep sending us your feedback, your pictures.
2. And rest. We have 15 seconds to rest.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we definitely want to see that. It's encouraging to know that you're watching these and making good use of the workouts. 5 seconds. We're going to hit those inchworms. 3, 2, and 1. Again, straight legs. If you're comfortable to walk out to plank and walk those hands back. Hips go back. Those Feel that hinging at the hips.
Forward and backwards movement there.
Focus when you get down into plank on a good straight line from your shoulders, hips, and heels. Keep moving. About 10 more seconds. One, 15 seconds of rest, then we're doing those heel touches, heel taps, high heel taps. Yeah. Makes it sound like you need to be wearing heels. Starting those in 5, 3, 2, and 1. Keep after it, come on. 5 seconds in.
Touch! No!
You got it, you got it. Keep with it, guys. Come on. Past the halfway point. Keep moving. This is the long round of these. Come on. Stay with it. 15 more seconds.
Ooh, legs are tired.
Legs, heart rate, everything. Come on. You got this. 5, 3, 2. And rest. Good. This round should be a little bit easier. We're going to do 30 seconds. 30 seconds of work, 30 seconds of rest. Starting in 8 seconds with lunges. We'll start on the opposite leg because I'm uneven from last time. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Just as low as you can on those lunges or toe taps. Remember, if you're standing and just balancing, back to the center every time, reaching that foot. Good. 10 more seconds. 3, 2, and 1. We are so close. 30 seconds of rest. And go back to those inchworms. Such nice weather. It doesn't look cloudy though. Like the sky doesn't look very blue today. Still a good temperature. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Hips go back. Reach those hands down wherever you can on the ground. Walk them out to plank. Walk all the way back. Again on a wall. Your legs are still staying straight. You're just walking those hands down and back up.
As low as you can without slipping.
You're doing great.
About 8 more seconds. 1 or 2 more of these.
3, 2, and rest. Good. 30 seconds on these heel taps. That'll be our last one in this section. Guys, 3, 2, and 1. Good big breath in through the nose. Move through these. Come on. Nice and quick. Touch those heels. Get them up high. Open up those hips. Let the knee drop. Pull that heel up. Come on. 20 seconds left.
Opposite leg to opposite, and you get a nice good twist. Extend that leg as far as you can.
And you're gonna relax those heels on the ground. We do reach throughs. So reach throughs, you're coming up, arms are, I curl my hands like this, and you're gonna reach through that side, working those obliques, okay? That third one, you're gonna roll up. It's a Russian twist. So you can have your feet down if you want for this one, and you're reaching side to side. You can have one leg up, reaching side to side, or a little more difficult, both feet up, side to side. You still got a nice, good rotation with both those feet down. Just kind of engage that core, you lean back slightly. The last one is gonna be a plank toe touch. So you're gonna be on your, in a plank position, and you're just lifting up that toe, lifting up the toe. You can also be on your forearm. If you need to be on your knees, that's fine. Just lift the knee up, lift the knee up. Again, you wanna engage that core. Doing all four of these exercises, okay? So let's go ahead and flip on over for the bicycle first. Again, this is a 45-second work.
It's a long set of the core.
Let's do it. But we got this. And we'll start in about 10 seconds. Again, if you need to use just your legs, if it bothers your neck to come on up, there's another option, okay? We'll start in about 5 seconds. So count hands behind your head. Bring those legs up. And let's begin. Extend and twist.
Breathe. Breathe.
As you can. Good, great job. Keep going. Got about 15 more seconds. Good, and 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good job. And those hold those feet down. The next one we'll do is those reach throughs.
And on this one too, leave that neck down if it bothers
you. Yes.
It'd be open.
Starting about 3, 2, 1, and begin. Reaching through, side to side. Two, and
job. Ooh. Remember, the next round will be shorter and you get a longer break. So 30 seconds for this one. Going back to that bicycle first. 5 seconds. So again, you can use those. Put your hands behind your head and begin. Extend that leg as far as you can. Way through, keep going. In 3, 2, 1, and rest. Whew. Good, next we have those reach throughs again, so soldier feet can be on the ground.
But first a long break.
Yes, 30 seconds. We got about 10 more seconds. So they cup their hands, reach through. Start in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Push their thumb up. More than halfway. Keep pushing. 5 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and rest. Roll on up. Two more to go. You got this. Brush and twist.
1 minute at work. Come on,
Seth. 15 more seconds. Halfway, keep pushing, 15 more. Five seconds. And 3, 2, and 1. Woo. Good job. All right, last one here. That plank, watch your position. Got 5 seconds. Keep those hands underneath your shoulders. And 3, 2, and 1. Here we go. 30 seconds. You got this. Almost there, 10 seconds, come on. And 3, 2, 1. Oh, great job,
guys.
Go ahead and get another sip of water, and then we have another AMRAP for you to go.
I'm gonna sit in this cobra for a second too after crunching so much. Good work, guys. Hold on to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady.
Welcome back. We have our next segment here. We're going to do a 4-minute AMRAP. Remember, that's as many rounds and reps as you possibly can. Rep scheme today is going to be 10, 10, 10. So we're in 10 reps of everything. First one's going to be a sumo squat with a calf raise. So sumo, think about sumo wrestlers, nice wide stance. Toes are pointing out pretty deeply. And all we're going to do is squat as low as you can. Send those hips back. Stand up. And as you come up, we're going to come onto the balls of the feet, just lifting those heels up just a little bit. So full squat as low as you can up onto the balls of the feet. Next movement, Natasha's going to show on our fence.
Yeah,
a fence. Okay, fence. You can use a chair, you can use a bench, whatever you have around. So we'll both show those two options. Shoulder taps, so we're getting in that good solid plank, straight line from your shoulders, hips, and heels.
you're just tapping that shoulder with that hand. You can tap opposite shoulder. Some people prefer to bring that hand straight up and tap the same shoulder. Doesn't matter, we just wanna get into, kinda like we did with those toe lifts a minute ago in plank, just wanna get into that tripod for a second, the three pieces of your body touching the ground at a time. And then the last one's gonna be mountain climbers. Again, you can modify on a wall, bench, chair, bringing those knees into the center as much as you're able, or you can be down on the floor in a mountain climber, take it as slow or as fast as you want. We're doing 10 total mountain climbers. Remember, the lower you go, the little more difficult. So this will be a little easier, a little more difficult, then obviously the floor would be the most difficult. But find out where it fits perfect for you, because we have a lot of these to do. The idea on these AMRAPs, remember, is to elevate that heart rate, really move through it quickly. So you don't want to be down on the floor having to take rest for those 10. You want to be able to move through them fast. All right, so we're gonna start in 8 seconds with those sumo squats. We're gonna work for 4 minutes, starting at 4, 3, 2, and 1. Squeeze that butt at the top. Come up onto the balls of the feet, come on. Ten of those shoulder taps whenever you're ready. And 10 mountain climbers whenever you get there. Keep cycling through those three movements. Come on, you're doing great. Job. Nice stable thoughts at the top of that sumo squat. Every time you do a mountain climber.
Get some drive-bys here.
A lot of traffic for some reason. Keep breathing, come on. Just under 2 minutes left, we're past that halfway point. Wide feet on those squats. Breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. Less than a minute left, come on. Almost there, come on, last few reps. Working for 5 seconds. 3, two, and time.
Good work. Take a quick walk. I'm going to grab my water. We're going to walk a couple times around this lawn. Pause the video for take about 4 minute walk.
Perfect.
Lower that heart rate, catch your breath, and we'll see you back in a few. Hold on to me, because I'm a little unsteady.
Welcome back. We're going to end another fun song again.
Shout out to, who is this one?
Mumford and Sons. Mumford, Roll Away or Roll Down the River or something with roll. Anyway, we're going to kind of keep moving throughout the whole song. And then when the banjos start playing, we're going to do four punches and two kicks. So four punches and two kicks. Starts off small and then it gets a little bit longer. So I'm going to start this song up. And we're gonna start with just some, let's do the front ones again. So over here, we're up, touching. Yep, here we go. Let's get some movement. And then I'll cue you when we start those punches and kicks. Good. Let's go ahead and switch the back now.
Oh, kicked my hand.
Good, I'm just gonna keep moving.
Roll away your stone, I'll roll away mine. Together we can see what we will find. Don't leave me alone at this time. For I'm afraid of what I will discover inside.
And now, punch, punch.
Within the fragile substance of my soul. And I have filled
your
this void with
I
things unreal. And all the while my character it steals. The darkness is a harsh turn, don't you think?
Bridges
have been burned.
Get a little longer each time.
You say that's exactly how this grace thing works. It's not the long walk home that will change this heart.
Don't kick yourself in the hand.
But the welcome I receive with the restart.
Skater? Oh, wait,
just get punched. Darkness is a harsh turn. And yet it dominates the things I see. Darkness is a harsh turn, don't you think? And yet it dominates the things I see.
Good. So the ice skaters now.
You've gone too far this
time. Great work.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. Send us your feedback and we will see you all throughout the week. Have a great week.
Bye.